Hello children, welcome to Samagra Siksha Abhiyan Digital Class. Myself G. Santosh Kumari, PGT English from TSMS Daultabad Siddipet. Children, before starting our topic, I have a question for you. Can you guess this person? He was a great scientist and became one of the presidents of India. He was also known as Missile Man of India. Yes, you're right. He is none other than APJ Abdul Kalam. Today, we are going to learn about reading A, My Childhood, from Unit 7, Nation and Diversity. My Childhood. My Childhood is an extract from Wings of Fire, an autobiography of the great leader Abdul Kalam. Do you know, children, what do you mean by autobiography? Auto means self, bio means life, graphy means printed or written work. Here, we are going to know about Kalam's birth and family, his inherited qualities, about his friends, how people lived together in Rameshwaram, his school incident, dinner incident, and his parents' decision for his higher education. Kalam was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. Kalam's father, Jainulabdin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. Kalam's mother was Ashiyamma. Kalam says that Ashiyamma was an ideal helpmate to his father. Kalam did not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but he was quite certain that far more outsiders ate with them than all the members of their family put together. Kalam was one of the children, a short boy with rather undistinguished look, born to a tall and handsome parents. They lived in their ancestral house, which was built in the middle of 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. Kalam's father was a simple and used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine or clothes. Kalam says that his childhood was very secure, both materially and emotionally. In 1939, when Kalam was 8 years old, the Second World War broke out. During that time, there was a sudden demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. Kalam used to collect the tamarind seeds and sold them to a provision shop in a mosque street. Do you know, children, Kalam's a day collection would fetch him the princely sum of 1 anna. Kalam's brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, used to tell him stories of war which Kalam would later attempt to trace in the headlines of the Dinamani. Rameshwaram, being isolated, was completely unaffected by the war. But soon, India was forced to join the Allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. Then Kalam says about his first wages. How did he earn his first wages? Let's know. Kalam had a cousin called Samsuddin who distributed newspapers in Rameshwaram. Due to the World War, there was a suspension of a train halt at Rameshwaram station. The newspapers now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on Rameshwaram Road. That forced Kalam's cousin Samsuddin to look for a helping hand to catch the bundles, and as if naturally, Kalam filled the slot and earned his first wages. Kalam says that he had inherited a great qualities like honesty and self-discipline from his father and faith in goodness and deep kindness from his mother. Then Kalam moves on to say that he had 3 close friends, Ramananda Shastri, Arvindan, Shivaprakashan. All 3 boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin family. Ramananda Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshmana Shastri, the high priest of Rameshwaram temple. From these three friends, Harvindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims. Shivaprakashan became catering contractor for the Southern Railways. Later, Ramananda Shastri took over the priesthood of Rameshwaram temple from his father, Pakshi Lakshmana Shastri. Abdul Kalam says that during the annual Sri Sita Rama Kalyanam ceremony, Kalam's family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of Lord Rama from the temple to the marriage site, situated in the middle of the pond called Rama Tirtha, which was near to their house. Events from the Ramayana and from the life of the prophet were the bedtime stories where Kalam's mother and grandmother would tell the children in his family. Kalam says an incident from his class. One day, when Kalam was in the 5th standard at the Rameshwaram Elementary School, a new teacher came to their class. Kalam used to wear a cap which marked him as a Muslim, and he always sat in the front row next to Ramananda Shastri, who wore the sacred thread. The new teacher could not stomach a Hindu priest's son sitting with a Muslim boy. In accordance with their social ranking, as the new teacher saw it, he was asked to go and sit on the back bench. Kalam felt very sad, and so did Ramananda Shastri. After school, they went home and told their respective parents about the incident. Lakshmana Shastri summoned the teacher and in their presence told the teacher that he should not spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance in the minds of innocent children. He bluntly asked the teacher to either apologize or quit the school and the island. Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshmana Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed the young teacher. That was the Kalam's childhood incident of school. Kalam's favorite teacher was his science teacher Shivasubramanyam Iyer. Though an orthodox Brahmin was something of a rebel, he did his best to break social barriers of the society. One day, Shivasubramanya Iyer invited Kalam to his home for a meal, but his wife refused to serve a Muslim boy in her ritually pure kitchen. Shivasubramanya Iyer was not perturbed, nor did he get angry with his wife, but instead, he served Kalam with his own hands. When Kalam was leaving his house, Shivasubramanya Iyer invited him to join him for dinner again next weekend. When Kalam visited his house the next week, Shivasubramanyam Iyer's wife took him inside her kitchen and served him food with her own hands. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was imminent. Indians built their own India, declared Gandhiji. The old country was filled with happiness. Kalam asked his father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathapuram. But Kalam's mother was hesitant. Then Kalam's father quoted Khalil Gibran's quote, "Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing itself. They come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have their own thoughts." Then, as everyone knows, Kalam has become a scientist, a great leader, and the president of India. This was about my childhood. I hope, children, everyone understood it. Thank you.